Hello everyone, Beata here, and welcome back to Fibers and Fabrics Season 2. Today's episode is number 3, and we are looking at semi-synthetic fabrics. When thinking about semi-synthetic fabrics, I find it easiest to compare it to paper or toilet paper. These are two items that every single one of us uses every single day. We all know that paper and toilet paper are made from trees, but of course it goes through quite a process for it to look and feel the way it does, and for it not to resemble trees at all anymore. The same happens with semi-synthetic fabrics. Yes, it is made from plants or trees, but it goes through quite a process before we end up with the garment looking the way it does. Semi-synthetic fibers are created by putting the raw material, being the plant or the tree, through a chemical process that turns the wood into a wood pulp, also known as cellulose. The cellulose then gets pushed through a device called a spinneret. When the cellulose gets pushed through the spinneret, small little filaments are formed and dried immediately when they exit the spinneret. A spinneret resembles the look of a shower head, so you can think of it in the same way. They are dried immediately to create the base of what we know as a semi-synthetic fabric. In the very beginning of semi-synthetic fabrics, it was only attempts at recreating natural fabrics and possibly improving them, or at least driving down the production costs of making natural fabrics. A Swiss-born chemist received the first patent in the 1800s for creating the first artificial silk. He made this fabric from the bark of mulberry trees. This progressed into Sir Joseph Swan creating the first rayon in approximately the same time as the first artificial silk. He used a very similar process to create the rayon. Rayon is hugely popular and is known to be extremely soft, moisture absorbing, and easily dyed. All semi-synthetic fabrics are created by taking plants as the raw material, mixing it with chemicals, and then producing yarn from this compound. The popular natural ingredients being bamboo, pine, eucalyptus, and beech. The reason why semi-synthetic fabrics are able to drive down the cost of manufacturing is because more parts of the plant can be used in the mixture. Something like the eucalyptus plant or the bamboo plant, more parts of that plant can go into the mixture that are mixed with the chemicals in order to produce the cellulose. Therefore, less parts of that plant is discarded after harvesting. With cotton, for example, you can only use the white fluffy part in the middle in order to produce your cotton. I've seen adverts where they say this t-shirt is made from eucalyptus plants. I'm not really sure if I see that as greenwashing or not, but it is definitely not only made by using the eucalyptus plant. It goes through quite a few processes in order to end up with the soft, smooth fabric that was advertised. Semi-synthetic fabrics have improved a lot over the last few years. There are many, many options available, different textures, colors, weights, and so forth. Fabrics imitating silks, thick and lightweight cottons, just to name a few. So why semi-synthetic fabrics? It is a way to optimize the usage of the plant. As mentioned, all of the parts of that plant can go into the mix instead of cotton, where just that white fluffy part can be used. The chemicals being used and the process that it goes through can give you the desired texture that you want. That is very different from the natural texture that it had originally as a plant. Therefore, it lessens the time and price in comparison to growing the perfect cotton. Examples of semi-synthetic fabrics are viscose, rayon, modal, copra and acetate. The semi-synthetic fabrics we have today is already very different from the ones we started off with in the 1800s, of course. But today we also have different qualities of these semi-synthetic fabrics. This makes a huge impact on the price of a garment, the wear and tear thereof, and how long it will last. A very fine viscose can potentially get washed and worn out a lot quicker than other forms of semi-synthetic fabrics, therefore ending up with an item that looks a little bit tatty. We have really good news when looking at semi-synthetic fabrics. A more sustainable version of semi-synthetic fabrics entered the market. This is where a closed-loop process is being used. This means that the chemicals being used to transform the raw plant into a cellulose gets used more than once before it is being disposed of. This is definitely much better for the environment. So far, we have the following fabrics: Tencel, Lyocell, and Lensing. So if you see these three, you know that you are definitely buying a better quality semi-synthetic fabric in comparison to the rest. The companies producing these semi-synthetic fabrics are also more aimed at producing a higher quality item with a lower environmental footprint. Another way to buy better semi-synthetic fabrics is to ensure that the plants are being used in the process are organically grown, whether it's from bamboo, eucalyptus, or pine. Make sure that those plants are grown organically. I must say, I am very excited to see what happens in the world of semi-synthetic fabrics with all of the research and development going into it. My hope is that semi-synthetic fabrics produced using a closed loop process with plants that are grown organically can replace the synthetic fabrics we use today. Thank you so much for watching today. Please do give this video a thumbs up if you've enjoyed it. That way this video will reach more viewers just like you who are also interested in semi-synthetic fabrics and also the future of our environment. Bye everyone!